I'm Elizabeth Hatley. I'm a chef in the Fergus Falls area, and I've developed some recipes using ingredients from the farmer's market. In this video, we'll be making marinated cucumbers and onions. You want to take two cucumbers, and if the skin is thin, you don't need to peel them, just thinly slice them. If the skin is thicker and more bitter, go ahead and peel them, and then thinly slice. And add two chopped green onions. You could also use half of a medium onion, thinly sliced. A quarter cup of vinegar, either white wine or apple cider vinegar. A quarter cup of water. Half a teaspoon of honey. One tablespoon of chopped herbs, whatever is available. Today we're using chives and thyme. Some sea salt and black pepper. And toss to combine. These are ready to eat, but they are best if you set them aside in the refrigerator for an hour and up to 8 hours to let the flavors come. In this video, we'll be making a wild rice with balsamic roasted beets and garlic salad. To roast the beets, take half a pound of beets and peel them and dice. Put them on a sheet tray. Take three cloves of garlic. Smash them with the back of the knife and remove the skins. Drizzle with 2 teaspoons of olive oil. 1 tablespoon of balsamic vinegar. Salt and black pepper. Toss to coat everything well and place in a preheated 375-degree oven. Roast until they are tender and brown in spots, about 20 to 25 minutes. After 25 to 30 minutes, check the beets, and once they are soft and brown in spots, take them out of the oven. Add to mixed greens, half a cup of dry, cooked wild rice. Cook it until it's soft and starts to burst. Add your warm roasted beets. And stir to combine those. To make the dressing, we have 2 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar, 2 tablespoons of honey. To make the dressing, we have 2 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar, 1 tablespoon of honey, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 2 teaspoons of Dijon mustard, sea salt, and black pepper in this jar. And we'll shake to combine. Pour over the greens and wild rice. Toss to coat. And garnish. garnish with the raspberries. In this video, we'll be making honey black pepper salmon. You want 4 6-ounce salmon fillets. Dry them off well with a paper towel. And sprinkle 1/2 teaspoon sea salt, 1/2 teaspoon ground black pepper, and just a pinch of cayenne. Add 1 tablespoon of olive oil to a pan that's over medium heat. While the pan is heating up, combine 2 tablespoons honey, 1 tablespoon of warm water, 1 1/2 teaspoons apple cider vinegar, and stir those together. Once the pan is hot, add the salmon, skin side up. Let it cook on one side until about half done, 3 minutes or so. This may take longer depending on the thickness of your fillet, but you can tell when it's done because it starts to turn opaque in color, from the pink to the slightly white. Using a fish spatula, flip each fillet and continue to cook another 2 to 3 minutes. Once the fish is just about cooked through and there's still a bit of pink raw salmon in the center, add 3 teaspoons of chopped garlic to the pan, along with the honey, water, apple cider vinegar mixture. Turn the heat to low and let cook for 2 to 3 minutes until the mixture becomes syrupy. If you need to add a bit more water, add up to 2 tablespoons.